Today we're talking about the Federal Reserve. Although with monetary policy going the way it is right now, they're not reserving much of anything. The Federal Reserve has dropped the interest rate to zero and announced $700 billion in quantitative easing. We're using all our ammo in the landing craft before we even get to the Normandy beachhead. Hey, at least the market's recovering by plummeting so low they triggered another automatic trading halt. Worst day since, I don't know, yesterday, probably. At this point, that feels like almost a force of habit for the markets. Today, I'm going to try to answer two questions. First, what was the Federal Reserve trying to do with these two very different policies? And second, why less than 24 hours after they were announced, are markets already saying, well, they really blew it with that one? This new policy was announced late last night, and I have been mainlining espresso ever since to get this video out. So let's get into it. I'm excited. First, let's talk about the Federal Reserve going on a $700 billion shopping spree. I guess someone had to buy government bonds, and just like last week, it sure as heck still isn't going to be me. The process of the government buying government bonds is referred to as quantitative easing, a phrase so powerfully unengaging when uttered at any party it will make nobody want to talk to you for the rest of the night. I know from personal experience.
Again, they restarted quantitative easing with $700 billion of purchases that they will unleash over the coming months. Not exactly sure what the timing of that looks like. $500 billion of that will be in U.S. Treasuries. $200 billion of that will be in agency mortgage-backed securities.
We're buying mortgage-backed securities again? Did the Federal Reserve just copy-paste our 2008 response and forget to change a few names? The problem the Fed is trying to solve here is that investors do not seem thrilled with financial markets right now. I mean, at this point, Tulsi Gabbard's campaign seems like a better investment. So they're selling their stocks and bonds and taking that cash right out of the market. That's fine, except it means that nobody's buying stocks and bonds, so everything just kinda slows down. Still, that sounds like a problem if you're on Wall Street, but let's bring this home to Main Street. When you take cash away from the big banks, the limited cash remaining gets a lot more valuable, because there isn't that much of it anymore. Financial markets have been freezing up in strange ways that suggested banks and other major players are hoarding dollars. That's driving up interest rates that major corporations, state and local governments, and even individuals taking out a mortgage must pay for credit. If you can't sell the investments you have, well, you're not going to start handing out your remaining cash unless the price is right. The Federal Reserve's answer to this is, fine, we'll pay cash for $700 billion worth of your investments, so that you do have the cash to make more loans to individuals. Referring to the $700 billion in quantitative easing, Mr. Powell said in his news conference that the primary purpose of these securities purchases is to restore smooth market functioning, so that credit can continue to flow. So there you have it, the Federal Reserve just solved the credit crisis. We'll be back to economic growth in no time. Wait, I'm getting word that we're not in a credit crisis, but rather a pandemic. Well, that's not great. Who's clamoring for a loan right now? I'd like a student loan. Wait, every school is shut down. Maybe a mortgage. I am looking for a new place to self-quarantine. I know, I'll just invest in my small company. Really take advantage of all that foot traffic and demand for products right now. So credit is about to be very cheap, but I have trouble imagining many opportunities for people to take advantage of that. This may sound bad, but we aren't actually risking that much as it seems either. You see, the Federal Reserve is not handing Goldman Sachs a comically large check for $700 billion. Instead, we're going into the open market and buying assets at their economically depressed prices. The last time we did this was in 2008, and the actual taxpayer profit on that bailout was about $350 billion, all in cash, most of which held down the federal budget over the past 6 years. Buy low, sell high. I mention this not to say that the federal government should get into the hedge fund game. But instead, I just want to let you know that that $700 billion price tag isn't as bad as it sounds. So now to the other big move that the Federal Reserve just made.
The Federal Reserve is taking sweeping action to try to protect the economy from the coronavirus. Fed Chairman Jerome Powell announced that interest rates will be drastically cut in one of the biggest Fed moves since the 2008 financial crisis.
Yup, the Federal Reserve just plummeted the key interest rate by a whopping 1% after lowering it half a percentage point 12 days ago. Talk about a fiscal cliff. So what's the problem that the Fed is trying to address here? Simple, people aren't spending money or consuming things anymore. Unless you're in the hand sanitizer or face mask businesses, of course. In which case, congratulations. So how do we get people to spend more money? If you said public health policies to mitigate the spread of the disease, you'd be wrong. Instead, lower the rate by which people's savings accounts pay and lower the interest rates that will be charged on new loans. That solves the pandemic crisis. Basically, the Federal Reserve wants you to get the same financial advice Nicolas Cage must have gotten in the 90s. Spend all your money, and then take out a loan and spend that money too. Don't save. The interest rate on your savings account is a quarter of a percentage point. Biggest profit you're ever gonna make there was that free toaster. Instead, put your money in the stock market to earn a quick buck. Or buy a new American-made TV. Of course, the problem we encounter here is the exact same problem we just encountered with the buying of $700 billion in assets. To quote Bloomberg News, it's largely inconsequential. The bottom line is this is a health issue. People are going to be surprised how little the economic incentives and plans are going to help until we start to see a change in the infection and death rate. And I would take a 5% improvement in the war against the coronavirus over an 100% move in terms of economic incentives and initiatives. The reason I'm not buying things right now isn't because I have so much savings and I'm getting a great rate on them. It's because they just shut down all the stores in my neighborhood except the grocery store, and I can only buy so many Milano cookies. Similarly, I'm not gonna go to my local mall right now and shop till I drop. I guess I could hit up Amazon for a major purchase, but I'm saving my money in case the price of canned goods goes the way of hand sanitizer. So that's exactly what the Federal Reserve just announced and why it isn't really moving the needle. If you want some cheap cash right now though, well, the federal government really wants you to have it. This brings us to the final question. What was the cost? Lowering rates doesn't come with a price tag, and that $700 billion in purchases might actually net us a pretty penny when this is all over. So was it just kind of a wash? Not quite, because we paid in opportunity costs. We can only lower rates to zero publicly once without raising them, and we can't do unlimited asset buying programs. To quote Bloomberg News again, they blew it. The Fed panicked and the market is spooked. The Fed has expended all of its conventional and unconventional tools. The key takeaway will be that they have truly expended all of their ammunition, and this is the action of a central bank that is scared. I like reporting on the Fed, but I'm not sure how much more monetary policy can be done at this point. So now, with the monetary pedal to the metal and every incentive we can conjure up to get people to borrow and spend money, the question is, will we, over the next few months or years, spend more with steady low rates? Or is this public health crisis going to continue to dictate our consumer spending patterns? Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I'd like to thank my patrons for helping me put out my videos. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan news looking into the overlooked, join this growing list of exceptional individuals by clicking on that link in the description. Also remember to subscribe and ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring. Give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw, and lastly, as always, thank you for watching.